This video will show you how to calculate the driving force of the M7C3 carbide as a function of carbon and chromium and plot the results as a heat map and a contour plot. The driving force is the change in Gibbs energy when forming a new phase, and it is crucial in determining whether or not a phase is likely to form. A larger driving force makes it more likely that a phase will form, but can also make it happen faster. If you are trying to determine the likelihood of secondary precipitation in a material, which can be both desirable or detrimental to alloy properties, it is useful to explore chemistries to optimize for the driving force of precipitation. This type of calculation can be done instead of performing the more computationally consuming simulation of precipitation kinetics. This calculation can be run by anyone with a license for Thermo-Calc, including the free educational package. The calculation is based on example T9 of the examples included with your software. You can access the example file by clicking the example files icon from the home screen of the software, opening the Thermo-Calc folder, and double-clicking on example T9. To begin the example setup, click on the One Axis template from the home screen of Thermo-Calc. Select the FE Demo database and the elements iron, chromium, and carbon. We will accept the default composition, so make sure your values match mine. When you calculate the driving force of a phase, you always need to change the status of that phase to dormant. To do this, select the Phases and Phase Constitution tab. Here we can see that all the phases are selected. We will be calculating the driving force of the M7C3 carbide precipitate from austenite, so we only need to select two phases, the M7C3 phase and the austenite phase. First, we will uncheck all the phases. Then select FCC-A1, which is the austenite, and the M7C3 carbide. We also change the status of M7C3 to dormant, since this is the phase for which we are calculating its driving force. Next, select the equilibrium calculator node. Set the temperature to 1000 degrees Celsius. Under calculation type, select grid. We are looking for the driving force of M7C3 as a function of two composition variables. So we will set those variables in the axis definition section. Set the first quantity to mass percent carbon with a minimum of 0 and a maximum of 1. We will use the default for the number of steps. Set the second quantity to mass percent chromium with a minimum of 0 and a maximum of 20. Now click on the plot renderer node. Set the plot type to heat map. The first two axis variables are carbon and chromium content, which we set in the equilibrium calculator. Set the third axis variable to normalized driving force. Set the phase to M7C3. Our calculation is now set, so select Perform at the bottom center of the program. Once the calculation is complete, your plot will appear in the Visualizations window. This plot shows the driving force of the M7C3 carbide as a function of the composition variables mass percent chromium and carbon, represented in a heat map. High values are represented in red, and low values are represented in blue. The pixels in this heat map are rather large, so to get a clearer view, you can increase the interpolation resolution. The higher the values, the clearer the plot will be. I will change interpolation to 100 by 100 and select Perform again. We now have a smoother plot. However, when you use interpolation, you should always check that the results did not change too much from the non-interpolated plot. In a heat map, each square corresponds to a calculated point. When you interpolate, the program guesses what the points in between should be based on these calculations. This can sometimes give you strange results when interpolating sparse data into a fine grid. So make sure the interpolated plot looks consistent with the non-interpolated plot. Our plot looks fine, so we can examine the results. Since high values are represented in red, we can see that the driving force increases as carbon and chromium increase, with the highest driving force in the upper right corner. If you hover your mouse anywhere over the plot, you will see the chromium content, followed by the carbon content, and the driving force at that composition. You can also view the results as a contour plot. To do this, change the plot type to contour. Check the automatic scaling box if yours is not already checked to give us a better view of the results. Then select Perform again. This allows you to see the values represented as lines. If we double-click on the top of the visualizations window, the window will expand to full screen and we can see the values more clearly. On the left half of the plot, we can see several instances where the driving force goes below zero. From a thermodynamics point of view, when the driving force is negative, the carbide phase will not form. When it is above zero, it has the driving force to form, but it is not guaranteed that it will form. We can see that these results match the results we saw in the heat map. If you liked this example, don't forget to press the like button. And feel free to leave a comment about the type of video you'd like to see next. We are constantly working to create new examples, so make sure to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out on any new videos. You can watch all of our videos at thermocalc.com in the video tutorials section.